Noise department.
Good morning. Thank you for your continued half-ass support of the Big Dumb Show, everybody. Gonzo's me. There's Don Stuck. There's Beau Asner over there at the news desk. There's Beau's little buddy, Fat Johnny.
Hi, Beau. Good morning, Beau. What's this wall he's built between us?
When did that go up?
What are those curtain gurneys like at the hospital?
Hi, Johnny.
Hi, Johnny.
Don't you love me anymore, Beau?
When would you let him in?
Never.
Actually, you need to start paying your child support, by the way. I'm paying for everything over here, and you need to start paying up, Beau. I'm not getting my checks to help feed this guy.
No. What? I actually, at one point, remember a couple months ago when I extended my barn?
Yeah.
I put that wing on my shed outside.
Oh, yeah, okay. Sure. Right. Yeah, kind of an addition to
it. Right.
Yeah.
I thought, what a great place for Johnny to come
and live?
And live.
You want him to live out there?
Dude, don't say that out loud.
Oh, there's no room now.
Oh, oh.
Big enough for a bus?
No, it's not big enough for a bus.
Is your driveway?
Yeah.
Hope your driveway's not made of asphalt. It's leaking some fluids.
It's okay. You can have a driveway in Greenwood without some sort of stain.
X103's road rage traffic.
You two just need to patch this up or figure it out.
No, we don't.
Yeah.
No, he just needs to stay over there.
Man, that only took 1 week, didn't it? He's back for 1 week.
He's been back for a month.
No, he's only been on one time, though.
Right. Bo's
up. Hey, Johnny, how you doing?
How you been?
You just need to stay over there.
Yeah. Stay over there.
Maybe a back massage. Maybe you
that's exactly what
get
you need.
Near me.
Give him a back rub.
Rub.
X103's News Free News.
Now, hold up there a second, Beau, before you go any further. I just want everybody to know that the magnitude of what a great day it is. And that is because those of you who have been with the show for a while remember probably what was one of the more, I don't know, life-changing events in the life of the show, and that was our pursuit of the giant Cheeto on eBay.
Oh, yeah.
Which we nearly obtained.
That was a turning point, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. And it led to a whole way of defining people based on nacho cheese or
Cool Ranch, or cool Doritos. Ranch.
Uh-huh. What side of the fence you want to stand on
that's nothing to do with anything. If you're a cool guy and you like Cool Ranch Doritos, you're at the party, you know, no big deal.
It's a party.
Party!
Party. Do you like the party?
Yeah.
On eBay today, we have a monster 2.2-ounce Dorito nugget.
Nugget?
Found in the great state of Texas. According to this photograph, next to a tape measure, it measures nearly 3 inches across.
No, wait, here's the dimensions. It's 1 3/4 in length, 1 3/4 inches in height, 1 1/4 inches in depth, and weighs in at 2.2 ounces.
Oh, I see it. Yeah. We have it.
Here, do you have it up on the computer there?
It looks like it's a Dorito the size of a small baseball.
The giant Cheeto that we were pursuing weighed a mere 0.6 ounce, this monster Dorito nugget weighing in at a full 2.2 ounces.
Wow. It would fill up, just one Dorito would fill up the corner of a large Dorito bag.
Yeah, it looks like. Found in a vending machine snack-sized bag of Doritos by an unemployed quality engineer while attending a mandatory help find you a job in Texas Workforce Commission seminar in Austin, Texas.
Looks like he found some work.
The bidding last time I checked at $122.
That's where it is.
And 50 cents.
I'm bidding on it.
Are you getting in?
You want it? Do we want it?
How many days left to go?
Eight.
It's got 8 days to go.
That's all right.
I don't know.
It's ours.
We haven't had any success with this in the past.
The Cheeto was such a disappointment that I'm not on board with the Dorito.
Are you serious?
I'm sorry. I've got to stand my ground.
It's a nacho cheese Dorito.
If you guys buy it, you're buying it on your own. I will not partake in the
you're not
going
to touch it or have anything to do with it.
You will not. You'll not be exposed to the fame and notoriety that it brings.
When we're on TV with Mike Ahern with our Dorito, we're not bringing you up.
Okay. I was so on board with the Cheeto. This is the problem with eBay. Okay? We're broadcasting about it now at 6:30 Central Time.
Okay.
As soon as the West Coast wakes up, somebody sees that we've jacked it up to $3,000 or $5,000 because of our contributor,
and influence of this program.
Right.
Uh-huh. Our benefactor.
All right.
They're going to start talking about it 2 or 3 hours removed from now.
Yeah.
It's going to be up to $99 million Sunday night, and it'll be pulled off the website.
No, this will be ours.
I don't think so.
Big Dumb Show, how much should we put in for this Dorito?
Man, I will fucking...
of course you will. See, that's the... You're the problem!
You can't say that.
God!
Damn.
Big Dumb Show, how much should we put in for this Dorito?
Hey, arriba, gandale!
Right.
Tito, you crazy, man!
Well, do we want it or what?
Put in $125.
It won't. It's $125 minimum.
Well, that's what I'm saying. $125.
You want it? You in?
$125.
All right.
All right.
Hold on. Beau, this is your last chance.
Fine. $126. I'll give you a dollar.
Oh, he's in for a buck.
Here's what it is. Whatever you guys want to put in, go a dollar more and I'll put that buck in.
No. Right.
What?
He's out. For a dollar, he's out.
All right.
What?
You're in for all or nothing.
You can have. It says it comes with some crumbs. You can have the crumbs if you put in a dollar.
For a dollar.
All right.
Man, I have about 15 pages of sports and 15 pages of entertainment news.
I'm getting ready to hit the button. This is your last chance, Beau.
I already said a buck.
You're out.
Nice sound effect.
That's great.
That's not a sound effect. It was a real live computer keypad.
All right.
Oh, I've been outbid.
What? That thing's going to go up to at least $150 right now.
It's a minimum of $130. We're having it now. I'm not having
it's going to go to $150.
This is where the trouble starts.
Nobody's outbidding me on eBay.
Remember, you didn't listen to me last time.
Nobody's outbidding me on eBay.
Jesus.
Here we go.
With that Cheeto, I played Kreskin. I knew how much it was going to go, and you kept...
Quiet.
Outbid.
I'm sure you've been outbid.
Absolutely no way am I outbid on anything. I've been outbid.
I tell you, it's going to be at least $150.
$135 minimum bid.
You've got to go to about try $151.
$151.
If you want to spend, if you want to spend $150, I'll give you that buck.
All right, hang on.
Sorry, Gonzo. This is. I know it's riveting and all.
I know. I'm pretty.
Now, people want
you got
their
it.
Show.
You got
to
it
have
right
it.
Now. They, you got
everybody
it.
Everybody wants us to have this.
Yeah, people want this.
Mm-hmm.
I've been outbid.
Holy crap.
This is awful.
$156 minimum bid.
Don't do it.
We'll look into
Teacher's credit bringing us this portion of the Big Dumb Show. Need money? Make money. Manage money.
Manage money.
Manage money. And don't buy stupid things. Stupid?
What the hell is this?
Gonzo Greg and the Big Dumb Show.
Hey, good morning. Gonzo's me along with the Big Dumb Show and our guest in studio, comedian, your old Uncle Larry.
Yeah!
Larry
is here. Hello, boys.
How are you?
I'm chomping on bacon here.
That's right.
That's some good bacon, isn't it?
That's good bacon.
That's Three Kings Catering right out there.
That bacon's Tommy Chong approved. That bacon is.
Did you send some to jail?
No, he was here. It was just before he went away.
There's something wrong in America, isn't it? When, Bin Laden's running around free, OJ's free, and
sure.
They're putting potheads in jail.
Yeah. Tommy Chong, very dangerous.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
very
yeah.
violent.
Don't want him running around.
Yeah, you don't want them bong. You could get hit in the head with a bong with him running around.
Yeah.
That's just not right. Well, Lair, you know what? It's a great time for you to be here. What with the Cubs?
Oh,
we've been
yeah.
talking about the Cubs nonstop now. And last time you were here, we were talking about the Cubs, and now look at them. Do you even recognize them?
Oh, yeah. I knew they were going.
Oh,
all
did
the
you?
Way.
Really?
They got the pitching.
Mm-hmm. I sure do.
It's exciting, too. Have you been watching? Exciting games.
Very.
I was in my basement smoking my cigar because my wife don't let me in the house with the cigar, so I got to go in the basement.
Very manly.
I'm down there with the dog smoking. I got so excited that first game I broke my jar of peanut butter.
Oh, no.
Jesus Christ, Larry.
Wow, you're
on. Yeah, the dog was hungry the rest of the week.
Well, this is, you know, I've always been intrigued, Larry, about your home life. I mean, here you have the basement to watch the game. You're down there smoking in the basement. I mean, are you allowed upstairs on, like, for Thanksgiving and Christmas?
Yeah, or? Just the holidays.
Holidays.
I go upstairs.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So there's the wife, there's the dog.
Cats.
Good cats. Yeah.
pets. Yeah, no, no kids.
No kids.
I'm against the kids.
Good for you.
Good for you.
Pets are better than kids.
Oh, yeah?
Don't you think?
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Well, because pets, they won't steal your booze.
Nope.
They won't wreck your car.
Yeah.
And if you accidentally kill one, no one cares.
Absolutely.
You kill a baby, you got trouble.
Then the cops and all the interviewing and all that stuff.
Oh, yeah, there's trouble. But a puppy, nobody cares about.
That's right.
Not that I'm saying you should kill puppies. I'm against that, too. But if it accidentally happens,
it's not that big of a deal.
It ain't that big a deal.
Right. You know, you've run over a driveway, something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's different when it's a kid.
Yeah.
No, just show the officer the bottle. Look how many times I've had to mark this bottle, officer. These kids are killing me.
They should treat kids like they do animals, too.
Mm-hmm.
Put them to sleep. Right? You got a bad dog, you put them down. If you're in kindergarten, you got a kid hitting all the other kids.
Right.
You know, Timmy, time for your shine.
We're going to the vet.
Yeah, we're going to the vet.
Riding a car?
Go for a ride. Stick your head out the window. Timmy's going to take a long nap.
What if a kid's chewing on cords, Bo?
Then what do you do? Yeah.
Got to do something about that.
Your kid's chewing on cords?
Yeah.
No, you should drop that kid off by the side of the road. Yeah. Take it to a strange neighborhood and let it out.
Yeah. Somebody will feed her.
Sure.
Father of the Year, Larry Reeb, with us on the program. Your old Uncle Lar with us on the Big Dumb Show.
Yeah.
What do you guys want to know about? You just give me... Give me something.
Well, we should talk about the Colts a little bit. Monday Night Football coming up with the Colts away.
Andrew might play.
No question he'll play. It's Monday Night Football.
He's going to be, quote unquote, available.
Oh, all right.
Available?
He'll be available.
Okay.
My guess is that Ricky Williams, James Mungro, and Dominic Rhodes are going to be sharing the running back duties.
That's a nice team.
They might decide to put the edge in, you know?
Right.
A couple plays, whatever.
Looking good on Monday Night Football with that new haircut. Yep, got to have him in.
Real move.
Focused on Edrin's hair there, Don.
It's because he looks fantastic.
I like his teeth.
His teeth? His gold teeth is representing?
Yep.
Yeah? You going to do that? Yes, you should do that. You'd look good like that.
Get some gold teeth there, Johnny?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Look at him just sitting there eating. Look at that.
He's eating on the air.
Yeah. That's nice.
Oh, yeah.
Man, you got biscuits and gravy.
Uh-huh. You got biscuits and gravy in your gold teeth.
Look at Johnny. You wouldn't think he would like biscuits and gravy.
No, you'd never get that, would you?
I thought you'd be eating cucumber salad.
What did you do to
He's got,
that?
Hold on.
Time out.
There's
he's
a
got a
level.
Corn dog, biscuits and gravy. Is that like a pizza puff or something?
That's a burrito, dude.
That's ravioli.
And ravioli.
A biscuit and two eggs and a piece of sausage.
It's the Fat Johnny diet.
And a burrito. Is that a burrito?
Yep.
Get off that burrito, biatch.
Jesus, dude, you're a mess.
How do you keep your slender waist?
Well, I have to bulk up for Christmas.
Yeah, he's Fat Johnny Claus at Christmas, and he lost some weight, so we do have to put it back on him. And he's got a ding dong, or what is that?
A cupcake for dessert?
That's nice.
Oh, you're Santa Claus?
Really? Yeah. He's Fat Johnny Claus.
Fat Johnny Claus.
Get to meet a lot of kids, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Trying to be a priest next, aren't you, Johnny?
All 14-year-old boys get a free spanking.
That's for Halloween. It's just creepy.
Halloween, he's a priest.
Yeah. You are a mess, Johnny.
That's a disaster.
Well, at least he's eating. You know, the last time he was in here, he fell asleep on the air. So at least we know he's conscious.
He was asleep and snoring on the air, Larry.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That was great.
That ain't good.
No, it's not.
The show's going
great. They don't say a lot about you guys.
No, sure. Sure.
Kind of rude.
The
it's rude, Johnny. Bad Johnny's making me sick.
I know the feeling, dude.
And I'm eating a fish sandwich that Don informed me was off a catering truck.
Yeah, Larry, you're having fish off a catering truck.
What, no sushi?
What the hell?
Why don't you get some sushi off the truck?
All the diarrhea should stop by your second set tonight.
Yeah, you'll be fine. Yeah.
Just drink a lot of water today.
I carry a colostomy bag just in case. You never know.
No, Three Kings Catering is great.
Yeah,
it's all good.
It's all. It's
Three
awesome.
Kings rude. Oh, here comes the plug. Oh, it was delicious.
Three Kings Catering.
See, the problem with the Friday thing is, now that Johnny's back, he's coming in, and you just, you know, look for them in the bankruptcy page, paper near you.
Some guy in a machine shop's waiting for the catering truck to show up. It does. There's not a thing left on it.
No. Yeah. Nothing. One corn dog.
He's cleaned it out. You bastard.
Looks like Fat Johnny, you know, not to be a hog.
Sure.
Got himself some low-fat milk.
That's to go with my cupcake.
Something to dip your cupcake with.
I'm not quite sure, you know, and I would be the guy right now that wants to change subjects because I want to do my job.
Yeah,
but I do have to bring up something here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Johnny has eaten all but about 2 bites of his corn dog, mm-hmm. 2 bites of his burrito,
right.
And now he's saving a little bit of his ravioli, and now he's working on the bacon and the sausage and the biscuit. I imagine he's saving a little bit of everything for round two, mm-hmm. so he can retaste everything.
Right.
Am I correct?
Yeah. Yeah. A little bit, yeah. Mm-hmm.
You are a mess.
Three Kings Catering should come up with something like they have at some of the restaurants, like the Old Country Buffet, you know, the big Herschel breakfast or
sure.
whatever. The Fat Johnny breakfast. Fat Johnny breakfast,
mm-hmm.
where it's just
the big mold of lard.
Yeah. One scoop of lard.
Like a jello mold,
sure.
only lard,
it's made of
with
lard.
Corn dogs and bacon and sauce
sticking out of it.
Yeah.
Like satellite antenna.
Yeah. And a big thing of gravy in the middle.
Sure. That's it. That's the Fat Johnny breakfast.
Are you back up to your what's your fighting weight yet there, Johnny?
I'm hovering at about 285, looking for about 10 more pounds.
Yeah, about 10.
You got to get back to the 300 area.
We got to keep you over 3.
Mm-hmm. For Santa, you got to be 3.
Yeah.
The chest pains though are more frequent now.
he was having chest pains the other
day. Dude, really? When you're heating up Crisco and then using a straw to drink it, that will cause heart pains eventually.
I'm sure we could trade you out a deal with a new Indiana Heart Hospital down the street here.
There you go. You gotta love a guy who laughs about chest pains.
That's right. Yeah.
These are chest pains. They're getting fixed.
Yeah, you gotta laugh.
My arm's all tingly. Yeah. That's hilarious.
Yeah.
There's a price sign. When you get that tingling feeling in your arm?
Mm-hmm. No.
Really? You don't?
No. He calls the other day and he says, so if your chest is hurting on the left side, that's okay, right? And I said, no, that's the bad side. And he went, okay. No reason.
Back to my Big Mac.
No reason. Yeah.
I can't believe that. There's a news item here, Beau, that we didn't get to. I think it was like last week.
Imagine that.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
Are you getting pissy with me?
Nope.
Ball's not a team player, is he? He's kind of feisty over there.
He's our feisty news guy.
That's exactly what he
that's
is.
That's his job description.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. Yeah, it's on the website. Feisty news guy.
I picked up on that, yeah.
Yeah, we probably had other things that we had to deal with, Beau, and we mm-hmm. just didn't manage to get to it.
Right.
Probably important stuff like...
Doritos.
Uh-huh, sure.
You don't want to talk to Uncle Lar. If you don't want to give him his time, then fine.
What are you talking about?
We'll just shut him down.
Uh-huh.
Sorry, Lar. You're done.
Thanks, Beau. Son of a bitch.
Yeah! Lar, that's not nice.
Hey!
Man, I really hope that wasn't too much of a you had to be there kind of thing, because that sounds like one of the funner shows in my recollection. Thanks for being here for the Big Dumb Show Flashback Podcast. Thanks to Uncle Lar, Larry Reeb. You can find him at UncleLarryReeb.com. Thanks, of course, to Don Stuck and Beau Asner. And oh yeah, Fat Johnny. And get over to gonzo.fm and look at all the other podcast options you have, as well as all the other stuff to look at and listen to. And remember, wherever you get your podcasts, please like, subscribe, do all that. I'm Gonzo Greg. The Big Dumb Show Flashback Podcast is a production of Noise Department, a boutique audio production house specializing in sound for commercials, web videos, podcasts, or, you know, whatever. Please visit noisedepartment.com.